It's your Bruno!
Can you still hear him?
Nope, just you!
Good! Now hang on!
So, I saw something, and it was like, yes, it's good that James stopped the prank. But if he hadn't, Snape would not have been able to tell Voldemort the prophecy, and then James and Lily wouldn't have died at 21. So, I was thinking, if James could have just gone back in time and stopped himself from stopping the prank, then he wouldn't have died. But the thing about James is he wouldn't have been able to do that, because Remus would be killed at the age of 15 for killing Snape. Sirius, Lily, and James himself would have been devastated because of that, and he would have gone the rest of his life hating himself for letting that happen. So if he had gone back in time, knowing that he would die if he stopped the prank, he still would have done it anyways, because he never would have put himself above his friends. He would rather have died than let Remus die. And he shows that later. He dies to try to save Lily. It doesn't work, sadly, but he does. And that's why I love him so much. He's so selfless. This is a part three of my why you shouldn't like Snape thing. In third year, in Prisoner of Azkaban, Snape took over teaching defense for Remus during the moons. And the first thing he did was have them learn about werewolves, even though that wasn't part of the curriculum yet. And Snape then made them write an essay on how to properly identify and kill a werewolf. Snape knew that Remus was a werewolf. He'd known for a while, and so he wanted the students to think that too, and he wanted that so that they could kick Remus out of the school so he wouldn't have a good job. And he also took away the opportunity for Remus to teach them about werewolves, for Remus to give them actually good information, instead of making them write essays about how to murder them. And Remus would then have to come in and grade all those essays about how his students would go about killing him. And Snape then, at the end of the year, went and told everyone that he was a werewolf so that he would lose his job. That's sick.
You're an awful person.
Maybe. But I'm rich and I'm pretty, so it doesn't really matter.
Trapped in, now I admire you, and that'll show you do. You're onto something, really, it's something.
Yeah, you're perfectly wrong for me. Hate that you know that I won't be.
Yeah, you're perfectly wrong for me.
Oh, yeah, you're perfectly wrong for me, and that's why it's so hard for me.
For a breakdown.
Never gonna get it, never gonna get it, never gonna get it, never gonna get it, never gonna.
This is a great question. I finished that book 2 days ago, and it took me a day to read, but it was a lot to chew on. I feel like with most of Taylor Jenkins Reid's books, it's, you can't just read it and be fine. Like, you have to chew on it a little bit. And tells the story of a movie star and how she started from nothing and became one of the most well-known movie stars ever. And it is incredible, beautifully written. It doesn't just tell the story of Evelyn Hugo, like, it tells a story from the narrator's perspective, from a different narrator's perspective. And it's beautiful, so go get it.
The night is on your lips and I feel like I'm locked in. There's a million lies, I don't care if they're watching. Your body saying everything, I don't have to read your mind.